everything is fine. Okay, and I hide this cooker bottom. Now here I press, sorry, I am not applied. I press the top cover and I press Ctrl A to apply the yarn solidify using a mouse which is covered on the cursor. I go to the edit mode and I create the edge loops for the same. I connect it in bottom using the shift key. I move it slowly and again I add it in here also. Using the shift I move it slowly. Okay, which looks nice. Now we are going to some bevel options here. So I zoom it here and here, here and here. It's very difficult to select because it looks very tiny and small. And I press Ctrl B to bevel. I make beveling like this. I reduce it slightly down and we look it. Okay, which looks nice. Okay, I press Ctrl Z. Z again, I press Ctrl R to create one edge loops and I press S to scale down. Now which looks nice more. And which doesn't look the same actually for us in cooker. So what I'm going to do, I just undo it and I create one Ctrl R and edge loops. I move towards here and I press 1 on the keyboard. I select these edges and scale it in X or Y, press 0. Now let me see how it looks. Fine. And this also, scale it in Y axis 0. How it looks? Better. And scale it in X axis 0. This one, scale it in X axis 0. Yeah, now looks better. So we are going to do the alignment this like this for the rest of the thing. So it takes time. So select these two, scale it in X axis 0, scale it in Y axis 0, scale it in X 0, scale it in Y 0. Okay, now looks better. Yeah, okay, which is required for us like this shape only in bottom of the cooker. I do the same for all the pieces. Go to edit mode, I press, select this, scale it in X 0, scale it in Y 0, scale it in X 0, scale it in Y 0. I press one edge loops here and I create it, move it here. Let's see, this looks fine. But this side we still not changed. So I scale it in X 0, scale it in Y 0. I select these two, scale it in X, scale it in Y 0. Okay, now it has been came correctly. So I change it for another thing. I hide this item. So using the H key, I select this two, X, scale it X 0, scale it in Y 0, skeleton y zero, skeleton x zero, and I create one edge loops here nearby that. Okay, I go to edit mode, I create this. Yeah, this looks fine compared to that. Okay, I do one thing, I go to edit mode, I press alt key and select these edges, I press double G to move towards a little bit further. Nice. And I do the same for this. Here I hide these two. I go to edit mode, I press numpad period key to zoom it in. Select these two, skeleton x0, skeleton y0, and I select these two, skeleton y0, skeleton, skeleton x0, and I create one edge loops here. Fine. Again, so I am doing for this every, all the edges which is required for us. So skeleton x and skeleton y axis 0, y axis 0, and select this, skeleton y 0, skeleton x 0, and now looks fine, and I create one edge loops here. This the same what we are going to do it here. Skeleton y0, skeleton x0, skeleton y0, 0, skeleton y0, why it's not happening, skeleton x0, okay fine, skeleton x0 and skeleton y0, and create one edge loops here. Now, okay, we have done almost for the everything. So now our top is ready with the requirement, basic requirement. So now I'm going to create a cooker whistle hook, and one more thing we used to say, I don't know what is that name, that also we are going to create. Now I go to edit mode. Okay, I go to top view using a summon on the keyboard. I go to the edit mode. Now here I'm going to create one whistle hook. Okay, so I scale it once again inside, and this size is good. Okay, I think so. Okay fine, let me create it in this size only. Shift D, right click to cancel, press P on the keyboard by selection, and go to edit mode and select that object. Go to edit mode and I press, let me see, so now we can able to see the scale is not even. So whenever you go on editing the scale, so it should be even. So I press Control A and apply the scale. Now it comes, the scale is even. Now we can go for the edit mode. I press A to select all and one on the keyboard. I press period key to zoom in. I zoom it out a little bit. E to extrude in Z axis. I slightly move it a little bit up. Z to extrude in Z. Okay. And G is Z. E to extrude scale, so let me zoom it like this. I scale it more. E to extrude in Z axis. So so I see it in front view, and we require more height, so I make it more. I press 1 on the keyboard, okay. G set, I make it more. Okay, now E to extrude and go more, and right click. E to extrude in Z axis, go more. And S to scale slightly up. And E to extrude in go more. And E to extrude, go more, and E to extrude Z axis, go more. And S to scale slightly down like this. Now our cooker top is ready, but it's not much clear. So I go to the edge selection. I go here. I go do this. Which one the beveling is? Let me do it. Just bevel the separate because it's not much more. Control B to bevel. I create one small edge loops here. I press Control 3. Shape smooth. Okay, which is okay for us. I select these edges, E to extrude in Z axis, let it go down a little bit. And I select here also one beveling, little bit more thickness. Yeah, this looks okay. And here these edges, I press Ctrl B to bevel. I get little bit sharper. Okay, and I select these Ctrl B to bevel, I make it little bit smoother. Okay, which looks the same here. And this here also, I go to edit mode, E to extrude and scale it tightly inside, and E to extrude in Z axis, I move it up to here. Now select these edges and I press Ctrl B to bevel. Okay, now the cooker bezel top is ready, so I hope the all size is okay. Which looks like a big, I press it, scale it down. It's not scaling in the same object because the pivot point which is there for that is, you can able to see it's in middle of the bottom of the cooker, so which is not required for us here also, even though everything is designed like that. So what I am going to do is select this object, go to the object, set origin to the geometry. So now the period pivot point is created here, and I do the same for this objects at origin to geometry. I do for this handle too, and origin to the geometry. So now this one I'm going to make it as bottom. This is enough because these parts, everything is going to join into the cooker only. Okay. I go to the solid view, and now I scale it down. I go to the front view, scale it down slightly, GZ to move towards down. Yeah, now looks fine. So now this is going to be almost, it's look like a cooker same size the hoses. So I go to the material preview and I go to the preview C. Yeah, which looks nice. Okay, now I go to the edit mode, I go to the solid mode. Okay, now this is ready. So far this is finished. I go to the top view, I press Shift Z or go to the solid mode, and I go to the edit mode for the cap. Here I'm going to make one circle design for the cooker whistling. Whistle means rivet we used to say in English. So I don't know what is that exactly. So I press 2 on the keyboard. I select these. Sorry, I using the key. Or press 3 on the keyboard. Oh, we have given the thickness now. Yeah, right. No. We have played. Yeah. Okay. I just missed out. I think I have not applied this. Okay. I press select this, and I right click, go to the loop tools. I'll create a circle. I go to the top view. And I scale it down because it looks like too big. And now I press Shift D, right click, P2, move by the selection. I go to edit mode. I hide this circle for now. So I tell you why it's required for us. So I select this and I make it GZ. GZ to go down slightly, little bit, and I create. Okay, press I to insert, and now I press GZ to go down tightly. Now it looks same like this. I think riveters went very long way. I think I just undo the same and okay. Yeah, this size is good. Okay, so now I press I to insert to create like this, and I scale it tightly down, and GZ to make this shape, and I use the edges to create beveling for this. Press Ctrl V and make the big bevel like this, so which look the same. Now I press 3 on the keyboard and I select these faces. Press Shift D to create a revert and P and create a selection. I go to the edit mode. Now we can able to see the scaling is wrong, so I press Ctrl A and apply the scale. I go to edit mode. I select everything using a face selection. I select everything. I show it here like this. Okay. And E to extrude and Z to scale. Okay, now I am created the edges like this. So I create one edge loops in bottom. I create one more edge loops in top. So which looks the same like this. Okay. Okay, let me make a little bit bigger. I just undo it. GZ. I go to the wireframe mode and I select these all the corners. And I press Ctrl B to make a small bevel to look like this. I right click Share Smooth. I go to the auto normals. Okay, everything is fine. Okay, now I have created this. Now we are going to make one more circle inside. I create instead of this. Okay, I create two edge loops here in between. Okay, which looks the model different, and we see what it happens. Okay, 7 on the keyboard, I press Shift Z and I press period key, so one key to create a select edge loop selection. I select all the edges of the corners. So now I press Alt Shift S to scale like a circle. So I move the mouse to make circle. Now you can able to see it's came like circle again. So this is the steps to create a circle whenever it's required additionally. So now I need to create one hole for this, for the revert. One hole is required in center and one piece is required to go down. So I press K on the keyboard to create a edge loops using here. I go on the top view. I press K. I press C to level evenly. Again I press C to level evenly. And I go here. Okay. Correctly it's matched. I press enter to finish that loop. Here the edge loop is not even, so I select this, I zoom it. You can able to see it is created like this. I select these two, M, I merge at center. So now here what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a circle in between this. I press 3 on the keyboard. And I press Alt Shift Yes. Okay, Alt Shift Yes is not working. So I right click and I create a circle again using this. I go to the top view and press R to rotate. And scale it down. I try to create one edge loop, it's coming. Yeah, it's coming. Okay, let's see. And it extrude in z-axis, so I make it here like this, so which comes the same. So I create one, I use the edge selection 2 on the keyboard and I select these edges. Sorry. So before that we have to do some edges here. Okay. I press 1 on the keyboard, I select these edges and I select these edges. I press 7 on the keyboard. Scale it in x-axis and scale it in y0 and I press gz to go down. No, it extrude in z-axis. Okay, z, control z to undo it. I go to the edges selection and let me try with GZ and E to extrude in Z axis. That also not happening. Okay, fine. So we have created the revert and I press 1 on the keyboard and 3 on the keyboard. So using these things, GZ to go down that to this and press 2 on the keyboard and I select these edges. So okay, now I have selected all the circle. I press Ctrl B to bevel, create one edge loops here to create a design like this, but it's not look like a circle. So what I'm going to do, I press Alt Shift Yes to make like a circle, but even though it's not look good, I right click and again I make it a circle and I go to the top view, rotate it. Okay, instead of creating the circle like this, we can create a pure circle, that is better, because sometimes it doesn't come what we expected. So I'm going to delete this one here in this. So I'm going to select this circle. I press Ctrl B and make one more bevel for this. It's small, which looks nice, so it's smooth. And here also we can create one edge bevel using the small, so which looks the same like this. So I select this one, this one, this one and I press GZ to go down. I press Ctrl B to make a bevel. Okay, we got the shape what is required for us. So I press I go to edit mode, I press Shift Yes, cursor to selected. So the 3D cursor will appear here. So
whenever the we create a new product, it will appear in the 3D cursor. I create a circle, I go to the top view, and here add circle, you can go to the, okay, we can create a triangle fan for this, and you can rotate in as per the view which is required for us, yes to scale. Now which is required for us, this type is okay. And now go to edit mode, press 3 on the keyboard and select all the faces. Before that we have to apply the scale, control E, apply the scale, and now you can E to extrude in Z axis. I press control 3, oops, it's look like this. Okay, I create one edge loops here, and I create some beveling for the same. You can turn off the subdivision in editing. Okay, now it looks fine, so we can create easily nowadays. I press control R, sorry. I press 1 on the keyboard, I select these edges, X to delete the vertices. Select these edges, X to delete the vertices. I select this one and go to the top view, E to extrude and scale. And E to extrude and scale. E to extrude and scale. And E to extrude and scale. Now we are going to create one circle here. So E to extrude and Z axis. Okay. Okay, I make it like this hole here. And I press GZ. E to extrude scale. E to extrude scale. E to extrude scale. I merge it in center. Now I press. Now we have to go a little bit down here. One item. So how we can do, I press 1 on the keyboard and we can see GZ. I create one edge loops here in between. Okay, now select these three and GZ, select these two GZ. Create one edge loops. Okay, I right click 2, I press control Z, select these edges GZ to move down. Now we can create this shape. Okay, I press control Z, I select these two and GZ. I go a little bit down, so I have created the edges like this, which is required for us. And if we create okay, I got one more idea. I press I to insert, create one edge loops, and now select these edges and select these edges, and I press GZ to move. And you can create one edge loops here, so which looks the same. And I create one edge loops in bottom, which looks like this. So I'm design the whistle like this, revert. So you can design as per your requirement, because revert whatever we keep, it's as per our requirement.
Sure, right, you can share smooth. Okay, now everybody has been created. So cooker basic thing has been ready. So we have to give some lettering and some work for this, so we can do it later. So we can start unwrapping. So I select this, you can go to all and yeah, press U and smart unwrap. I click OK. Then go to the UV editing section. Now we can able to see smart unwrap is very easy to create your modeling. So why I did this time like this is for this I'm not going giving any texture and modeling for this. That's the reason I did like this. Even this also same, I'm not giving any textures for the same. I press U and smart UV unwrap. I click OK. Now here also it comes very nice. We can give some textures if required. Okay, right. Now I go to the edit mode, sorry, object mode, and again I go to this. We can select everything. I press smart object LBC whether it comes correct. Okay, which is required for us, it came very nicely. So which is we required for us for designing. So I press Ctrl L. Okay. Now we can pack the island easily. I press UV and pack the islands. And here, what is this mean by press or Ctrl? Okay, fine, fine. I want to know whether it's the same or okay, same thing only. Okay, it's not a issue. What is this? Press Ctrl L. So this Ctrl L. Okay. I go to the wireframe mode and see what is that. Press 3 on the keyboard and I select these. Okay, these cuts. Okay, not a big issue. Okay, now I go to the edit mode. I go to the sub. Now we are finished modeling the cooker. Now we can go for the handle for the same. Okay, so I'm going to use the same handle for this. So I select this one, go to the right view, shift D to duplicate and Z axis, and we are going to do like this GZ and GX Y to move it in Y axis. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to edit this one. Go to edit mode, summon on the keyboard, shift Z, and I go it in layout, better we can do it like this, shift Z, and go to edit mode, and Y press 1 on the keyboard, I can G move here, sorry, G, Y, Y to move here, G, sorry, I press Ctrl Z, G, Y to move here, select this one, G, Y to move, slightly inside. And I select these thing, G, Y to move slightly inside. So now it is matching the same in the bottom. Now this top, what we are going to, you can go to edit mode, 3 on the keyboard, shift Z, and I select these top edges, and I select this one and I press G, Z to move slightly down. And I select the top of the these and E to extrude in Y axis. Okay. Now this cooker we have designed as per requirement. Now our handle is ready. And even this handle is, it's looking like it's very bottom GZ to move towards here. Okay. And I make it this also a little bit move towards top GZ. Okay, now our cooker is ready. So here is our designs of the cooker, what we have done. So we can go for the final rendering view for this. Okay, final joining and rendering view for the complete cooker. So, and here the visual is not coming. Base color. Fine. So, here for our that basic cooker is ready completely with the top thing. But we have missed out to design one more model. That is the whistling thing. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to design it now. So, this video is going to be big. I think it's almost recorded 1 hour. Okay, let me do one thing. Let me complete it in this part. So, next part, we can look into the model of designing the giving the patches and designs for the same. Okay. Now we can go to the final step. So our design has been finished. So we are next thing we are going to design here the whistle hook which is required for us, and we are going to model what to say? Sorry. Sorry. Next texturing we are going to do. How we are going to do that? Let's look into the next video. Bye bye.